In this video, we'll review the simple steps for setting up your new dedicated IP. Remember, you can enable captions in your language by clicking the video settings gear icon. IP addresses are tools used to send and receive digital information like email messages. While SendinBlue delivers email for many users from our shared IP addresses, we also enable our users to send from a dedicated IP address. A dedicated IP is reserved for a single sender and is only used to send their messages. After purchasing a dedicated IP, you'll receive an email confirming your IP address and providing instructions for setup. While setup is easy, it's important to follow the setup steps carefully. To set up your IP, you'll log in and update settings in your domain hosting account and your SendinBlue account. Before getting started, ensure you have access to your domain hosting account or provide these instructions to the person who manages your website. Let's get started. In your SendinBlue account, start by navigating to the Senders and IP area, then clicking on Dedicated IPs. Click on Associated Domain to set up an IP. First, select a new domain or subdomain to associate with your IP address. It's important to choose one that is not used for any other purpose, including hosting your website or company email addresses. It is safe to use a subdomain of your website's domain, for example, news.yourwebsite.com. You'll see two methods for associating it with your IP address. You can choose to automatically delegate your domain or subdomain to SendinBlue, or you can manually update your DNS records. When selecting a configuration method, you will be provided with specific on-screen instructions. You will need to log in to your domain hosting account to implement these steps. The second method involves more steps than the first and is primarily recommended for users who are already comfortable with managing DNS records. If you don't have a domain or if you are unable to configure the necessary records, please contact our customer care team for assistance. We'll be glad to help you. If you are reserving a new domain or creating a subdomain, choose one that relates to your organization's email or communications so that its purpose is clear. In this example, we are using news as our subdomain. Next, we'll log in to our example domain hosting account to delegate this subdomain to SendinBlue. We will complete these steps in GoDaddy, a common domain hosting provider that allows you to create and delegate a subdomain. Our Help Center includes tutorials covering these steps for several other popular domain hosts. Please keep in mind that your provider's rules, settings, and processes might be different than those shown in the example. It's important to contact your provider directly if you have any questions or need more information to update your settings. Many providers can even help make the updates on your behalf. After navigating to the DNS management area in our domain hosting account, we can create the subdomain. The host is our desired subdomain, and it should point to our SendinBlue IP address. Next, we'll add the two name server records provided in the SendinBlue instructions. The host is still our subdomain. We can copy and paste the name server records directly from SendinBlue. Once you have completed the setup steps in your domain hosting account, return to the Associated Domain page in SendinBlue. Click the Refresh button to confirm the configuration is complete. Remember, it may take up to 24 to 48 hours for your domain hosting updates to fully propagate. You can return to this page anytime to check the configuration status. Once the configured status appears, click the Validate and Confirm button to save your settings. Next, navigate to the Senders tab. If this is your first dedicated IP address, any previous sending identities have been automatically removed and you will need to recreate them. Otherwise, you will only need to update your existing senders. Click here to create a new sender. Input your from name and email address. We recommend using a sender email address that is associated with your website's domain rather than your IP's subdomain, For example, newsletters@yourwebsite.com is more effective than using newsletters@news.yourwebsite.com. Next, click Add and choose the IP address to associate with your sender. If you have multiple IP addresses, you can repeat this step to associate the same sender with multiple IPs. You may be asked to verify your new sender email address. If this is necessary, you'll be prompted on screen. If your SendinBlue account was not validated at the time your dedicated IP was purchased, you will need to complete any remaining steps on your account dashboard. Once all steps are completed, a member of our team may need to review your account and confirm that your setup is correct before you begin sending emails. When you no longer see a message like this one on your account dashboard, you're ready to start sending emails. If you have a question about your account status, please contact our customer care team anytime. Thanks for exploring SendinBlue with us today. Watch the next video in our series and learn how to prepare your IP to successfully send your desired email volume. To explore more resources about managing your dedicated IP address or other SendinBlue tips, visit our Help Center anytime. If you don't already have a free SendinBlue account, visit SendinBlue.com to create one.